Hi, I'm Prashanth Elangovan and welcome to our channel for all things aviation. In this video, part of the private pilot series, I will be covering the forces that make aircraft turn. By the end of this video, you will know exactly what makes an aircraft turn. We'll talk about Newton's first law, find out how forces called centrifugal and centripetal do their magic, and explore the secret of the horizontal component of lift. But wait, there's more. We'll uncover the mysteries of resultant load and resultant lift. Check out the powerful G-forces, figure out what skidding and slipping mean in an aircraft, and understand the secret behind a balanced or coordinated turn. We have got our four basic forces, lift, weight, thrust, and drag, while we fly straight and level. But when it comes to turning an aircraft, there are extra forces joining the party. Now, here's where Newton's first law comes into play. It says if a body is at rest or moving at a constant speed in a straight line, it will remain at rest or keep moving in a straight line at constant speed unless it is acted upon by a force. For an aircraft, that means if it's cruising straight, it will keep doing that unless we make it do something different, like turn. And guess what? Turning needs a special force. We call it centripetal force. It's like the force that helps your car take those awesome turns on a racetrack. Now let's delve into centripetal force. Imagine a ball tied to a string, moving in a circle. The string has a dual role. It maintains the ball's circular motion and prevents it from veering off course. The force responsible for keeping the ball in its circular path is known as centripetal force. In this example, it is the string that is exerting this centripetal force. Release the string and the ball strives to travel in a straight line, departing from the circle. Throughout the turn, it experiences a force pulling it away from the center of the circle. This force it experiences is called centrifugal force. Spin the ball with increased speed and you'll sense a stronger pull, a stronger centrifugal force. So, in simple terms, centripetal force ensures things stay on course, circling and turning smoothly, while centrifugal force attempts to tug them away. Let's see how these forces work when an aircraft turns. Imagine an aircraft making a turn. The path it takes in a turn is like a tiny curve, and if you stretch it out, it forms a circle, just like the ball moving in a circular path. Remember, to make an aircraft turn, we need a special force called centripetal force. So, how do we get this force? There is no string in the sky to turn the aircraft. Interestingly, this is done by using part of the lift force that the wings create. When we turn, we take some of that lifting force and divert it sideways into the turn. This sideways diverted lift force is called the horizontal component of lift, or HCL, and this becomes the centripetal force. Usually, pilots feel the aircraft is sinking in a turn, and it does. This is because we've used some of the lift that is carrying the weight of the aircraft and diverted it towards the turn. Because of this, the lift acting against gravity is a bit reduced. So we call this reduced lift the vertical component of lift. Therefore, while the aircraft is turning, lift has three parts: the horizontal component of lift acting as the centripetal force in the turn, the vertical component of lift acting against weight, and then there is the resultant lift. This is a mix of the horizontal component of lift and the vertical component of lift working together. Now remember the centrifugal force pulling the ball away from the center of the circle? This acts on the aircraft in a turn as well. Now, during a turn, there's also a combination of the aircraft's weight and the centrifugal force, making another force called the resultant load. This resultant load puts some extra force on our aircraft's wings. It feels like weight has been added to the aircraft. Now, if your aircraft turns more steeply, something interesting happens. The centripetal force caused by the horizontal component of lift and the centrifugal force both become stronger. This results in an increase of the resultant load on the wings. We measure this extra load with something called G-force, or just G. G stands for the force of gravity. So as our aircraft turns steeper, the G-force increases, making the wings feel like they're lifting more weight. Let's talk about load factor. Load factor is like how heavy the aircraft feels. It's a bit like when you feel squished in your seat on a roller coaster ride. That is load factor, or sometimes called G-force, making things feel heavier. Now, if you make a turn, we know that the load factor increases. This is because the resultant load increases in a turn. Imagine you have a big backpack and the regular weight is like wearing it normally. That's 1G. If the increase in load factor is expressed as 2G, it's like the weight of the backpack has doubled and feels twice as heavy on your shoulders. This is now a load factor of 2. Pilots need to be careful not to make the wings carry too much load, especially in turns, because the steeper you turn, the heavier the load becomes. There are some standard turns and their load factors useful for pilots to know. These also help us understand how load factor increases with increase in the bank angle of the aircraft. Let's use an example of an aircraft's wings carrying a load of 1000 kilograms and see how much the load on the wings change as the aircraft turns steeper. In a medium turn, at 30 degrees of bank angle, the wings experience a load factor of about 1.2G. That means for the wings of this aircraft carrying a load of 1000 kilograms, it will feel like the load has increased to 1.2 times. That is, like the wings are now carrying 1200 kilograms rather than 1000 kilograms. In a steep turn, at 45 degrees of bank angle, the load factor is now increased to about 1.4G. Now this would feel like the wing load has increased to 1400 kilograms. Going even steeper, like a 60 degrees bank angle turn, it's a hefty 2G. This is double the load, like the wings are now carrying 2000 kilograms. And at 75 degrees turn, the load factor shoots up to about 3.9G. Like the wings are now carrying 3,900 kilograms, nearly four times more. Now the amount of load wings can support have limits depending on what kind of aircraft it is. For regular aircraft, like the ones you see at the airport carrying passengers, they can usually manage up to 3.8G. But if pilots push it too much, they might accidentally cause structural damage or in extreme cases, even break the aircraft. Some aircraft, like the ones doing tricks in the sky, the ones built for aerobatics, can handle even more, like 6G. But for everyday flying, it's crucial for pilots to keep an eye on the load factor. Turning too steep can be like overstuffing your backpack and accidentally breaking it. Pilots definitely want to avoid that. Now let's chat about something that might feel familiar, like when you're riding your bike or driving in your car, taking a turn. If you're not slowing down in your turn, sometimes you may have experienced your vehicle skidding. Well, skidding can happen when an aircraft turns as well. This happens when the centrifugal force trying to pull the aircraft out of the turn is stronger than the centripetal force that is keeping the aircraft in the turn, causing the aircraft to skid. This works in the opposite way too. If the force that keeps the aircraft in the turn, the centripetal force, is stronger than the centrifugal force, then the aircraft does the opposite of skidding. It moves towards the center of the turn, and we call this slipping. Neither skidding nor slipping in a turn are desirable. When an aircraft turns without skidding or slipping, both the centripetal and centrifugal forces are equal. We call this a balanced or coordinated turn. This is the ideal way to turn an aircraft for better performance. So you see, turning is not just about changing direction. It's a delicate dance of multiple forces in the sky. And there you have it. You have just cracked the code on centrifugal force, centripetal force, horizontal component of lift, vertical component of lift, resultant load, load factor, skidding, slipping, and balanced or coordinated turn. Impressive, right? Why not test your newfound knowledge by tackling the questions in the description below? It's a fun way to see how much you've learned. Plus, it'll be super helpful for any tests you might have if you're training to be a pilot. If you enjoyed this adventure through the skies, please give us a thumbs up to support our channel. Feel free to drop your thoughts in the comments below. And hey, share this video with your buddies who might want to join the fun. Until our next exciting journey, remember to stay safe and happy landings.